Who would have thought that NASA's 1960s technology would still be saving hundreds of lives 50 years later? Here are the facts about this amazing technology.
What would happen when this type of Apollo capsule would be hurtling towards Earth? It would actually be, when it crashed into the Atlantic Ocean with all the parachutes. When the parachutes fly off, they need another thing to hold them up. So they grabbed the life, so that the capsule had a life raft on the bottom, and NASA was worried about the high winds that the helicopter was making. And there also was the Navy girl and divers waiting by the capsule so they would be able to get the astronauts out. And they had the ballast system on the bottom, and it would fill up with water so it would only tilt and not flip over.
Okay.
They were attaching the raft to the bottom of the capsule, which is right here, and they would attach it to it so the raft wouldn't flip over. Like I was talking earlier about, they had the bottom of the raft covered up in a thick layer of plastic and had it go deeper underwater, and they had holes in it which would fill water up in it so it wouldn't flip over. And Jim Gibbons had an idea of using the Apollo life raft. NASA had the idea of making a actual life raft with them. They used them to save hundreds of lives. It is called a hydrodynamic stabilization ballast system. It was used so the raft would not collapse and flip over and fill up with water and have the people inside of it drown. It's used by the Navy and Coast Guards. They use them when they have hurricanes and people's boats are being sunk. When their boats are being sunk, they know that there's a warning somewhere, so they grab some life rafts, but they don't inflate them yet. So when they get out to the area by where the boat sunk and where all the people are, they press a button and the life rafts would turn to the regular size. And they would be better, so they would be able to save them. Keep the life raft from tipping over because of the ballast system on the bottom of it. It would fill up with all the water, the 2,000 pounds, and it wouldn't flip over. It would only start tilting a little bit because of the high winds of the hurricane. And the way it works is the bottom of it, of the life rafts, since they're filled up with water, they really will only be tipping over, and if they go to the side, it will come back up like those punching bags that have water on the bottom of them. This actually is a picture of the Gibbons life raft, and you can see the ballast system on the bottom and the holes right there where the water would fill up in it. And this is the main part of it where the astronauts would, where the people inside of the life raft would stay and survive. It wouldn't tip over at all because of its ballast system. It only takes 30 seconds for it to fill up, 30 seconds or less to fill up the ballast system with water. And it fills up, in 30 seconds or less, it fills up 2,000 pounds of water. So it won't start tilting over and over and flip. It only takes a...
There are over 450 people alive today because of this NASA technology and Jim Gibbons. Their lives are my proof that this is the best NASA technology being used today, and many more lives will be saved in the future because of this technology.